Good morning, dear students. This is your science teacher, and today I am going to teach you science again. Today we start our new chapter of science IIT, that is magnetism. It is a very important part of our daily life, and we see at many places. So this chapter is very important. Okay. So before starting this chapter, there a need to know about a famous scientist, Michael Faraday. He is a British chemist and physicist, and he contributed a study of electromagnetism. In last chapter, we already discussed on the electromagnetism. Okay, so he contributed to study the electromagnetism and electrochemistry. And his remarkable discovery includes the principle of electromagnetic induction and diamagnetism. And he discovered many things, and these are in his discoveries include some most important things, such as the principle of electromagnetic induction. Induction means induce electromagnetism by the flowing of current into a wire, conducting wire, and diamagnetism. Okay, and laws of electrolysis. So, okay, and his research on the magnetic field around a conductor carrying a direct current. So, what is magnetic field? Magnetic field we not discussed. Suppose a wire and the electric current will flow through this wire. So when current is flow through this wire, so near the wire a field is generated, and it deflects and it shows the magnetic effect near the wire. This field that affect the magnet when current is flowing from the conducting wire. So this field from here to here, this field is known as magnetic field. Okay, if we are place a compass needle, we know that what is compass needle. It is shows the directions because it a magnetic field into it, north, south, east, west. If this compass we take to the near of this wire of a flowing current, a wire which have flowing current continuously, and when we take this compass near to this wire, what we see that the compass needle show the deflection. Means it show the it's show the deflection means it show the different directions. It deflect from their original position, basic position. So it shows means if we take this compass near a magnet, if we take this compass near the magnet, so what we see that the compass near the magnet also show the deflection. It means the wire in which current is flow is also shows the magnetism. It also create a field. Okay, that name is magnetic field. Okay, helped him to establish basis of concept of electromagnetic field in physics. Okay, so this magnetic field also established. Help him to establish the concept of electromagnetic field in physics. And Faraday also established that magnetism could affect the rays of light, and there was underlying a relationship between two phenomena. Okay, it's also established the magnetism it's affect the rays of light. Okay, his invention of electromagnetic rotary device. It's an invention of Michael Faraday is electromagnetic rotary device. That laid the foundation of technology of electric motor, which laid the foundation of technology of electric motor. We know that what is electric motor. We use that in our daily life at many places. Okay. It largely due to the Faraday effect. It was largely due to the Faraday effect that electricity become now these days electricity became practical for use in technology only because of the Faraday's discoveries. Okay, Faraday's effort. And he is born in 1791 and he died in 1867. Okay, he's a famous scientist of Britain. And then we start, and then we see the which topics are coming in this chapter. In this chapter, we discuss on these different topics. Magnets, we see the magnets in the chapter, and the material which attract the magnet or not. That material are called magnetic or non-magnetic materials. And a magnet shows two poles, north and south. So we discuss the poles of magnet. And properties which shows by magnet, we discussed in this chapter. And methods of magnetization. Magnetization means making of magnet artificially. So there are two methods for the preparation of, for the formation of magnet artificially, mechanical method and electrical method. Okay, and another topic, two types of magnet we discussed, temporary magnet and permanent magnet. Okay, and the next topic, demagnetization, we see how the magnet lost their properties of attraction, power of attraction is lost. So this this process we call demagnetization. Okay, and uses of magnet we see, and how to store magnet properly, how to store magnet properly we discussed in the last of this chapter. So our first topic, so before starting the chapter, there is a need to know about the history of magnet. So a story behind the discovery of magnet in Turkey, a place that name is Magnesia, where a shepherd getting a flock of sheep for tending, and he stand on a rock. He stand on a rock, and what he feel? He feel that his boots stuck to the rock, and his tip of staff is also got fixed on the rock, and the shepherd. What the name of the shepherd? Magnes. And the rock was named as magnetite. Okay, so this is a natural magnetic rock where the his shoes and the tip of staff is stuck. So this is a natural magnetite rock, that is. And the attractive power of magnet create a great amount of curiosity to explore its nature properties and uses. And this unique power of attraction of the magnet create great curiosity in our mind, and in everyone is very curious about the magnetism, how magnet attracts the things. Okay. So, explore its nature, curious to explore its nature, its properties and its uses. Okay, do you know Earth is also, the Earth on which we live is also a giant magnet. It's also work as a magnet. Okay, it is a giant magnet. So when you have, so by an example, we can understand, suppose, in your home, when we open the refrigerator door a little bit, you feel that the door is open very open, some tightly it's open. There is a need to apply a force to open the door, and after some time you see that it shut itself about this closed door. Okay. or cup cup boat door, and you feel something pulling the door itself. You feel that something is pulling the door itself. Do you know what is acting behind all this? It is a magnet. What is this? Magnet. So our chapter is magnetism. The property of attraction is known as magnetism, or the power of attraction is known as magnetism. So first we see the magnet. What is magnet? Magnet is a object. Magnet is a object that attracts the things made of iron, nickel, cobalt, and their alloys. We know that magnet is a material which has a special property to attract the things which are made up of iron, nickel, cobalt, and their alloys. Alloys means a metal which is made up of by the mixing two or more metals or non-metals. Okay. Suppose we mix alloys means, for example, stainless steel is also an example of alloy. Stainless steel is made up of iron, nickel, and chromium metals mixture. Okay. Oh, so come back to the point. It got its name, magnet. It got its name from the name of its discoverer. Who the discoverer? Magnes. We already discussed here, Magnes as a word. So the name of magnet on its discoverer, Magnes, who live in the place called Magnesia, and that place is known as Magnesia in country, which country? Turkey. Okay. Magnesia is a district in Asia Minor where a large deposit magnet rocks are found. Where a large deposits of magnets are found. The rocks which have magnetite are found in this district. Okay. Earlier, these naturally occurring material in early days, this naturally occurring material that attract iron is known as lodestone. Then later the term magnet was given to this material. Okay, so the type of material, the material which is attracted by metal or not, on the basis of this property, material divided into two categories on the basis of magnetism: magnetic material and non-magnetic material. And in our surrounding, we see that all materials are not attracted by metal. Not attracted by metal. All matter. All materials. Why? Because it is some have property to attract with metal, and some are not, and some have are in small or less property of attraction. Okay. So the material which attract by magnet, this type of material are known as magnetic material. For example, iron, nickel, cobalt, and alloys of these substances. Okay. On the other hand, the material not attracted by magnet are known as non-magnetic material. Okay. Such as wood, plastic, silver, gold, rubber. These materials are not attracted by magnet. Okay. So depend upon the behavior of material towards the magnet. Material is classified into three categories: paramagnetic material, diamagnetic material, and ferromagnetic material. Okay, so the paramagnetic material, the materials which are feebly attracted by magnet. Feebly means poorly attracted by magnet. This type of material are called paramagnetic material. For example, platinum, chromium, and aluminium. And the second category, diamagnetic. These are the materials that cannot attract by magnet. Okay. Air, water, copper, bismuth, etc. Such materials repel by the magnets. Okay. And the third type of material, ferromagnetic. These materials show strong attraction by magnet like iron, cobalt, nickel. Okay, and magnets, there are two types of magnet, artificial magnet and natural magnet. So why the name of these two types of magnets, we understand that which type of magnets are there. Natural means the magnets which occurs naturally. We know that limestone, lodestone, which is found from the rocks, are natural magnet substance from the rocks, be naturally occurred. Okay, so this naturally occurring substance which attract magnetic substance, so it's called naturally magnet. And build the magnet made by man are called artificial magnet. Okay, so there are different shapes of magnets are there, and these are coming in the different shapes and size depend upon its requirement. Its shapes in these magnet, what shapes it have? Horseshoe magnet, this is horseshoe magnet, like horseshoe. U-shaped magnet, this is U-shaped magnet. And button, some are button-shaped magnet, and cylinder-shaped magnet, and ring magnet. And another one is bar magnet. Here they show bar magnets. Okay, I think it is enough for today, but it is very important. So you watch this video, and if you have any doubts, you can ask. Good luck.